Our gentleman here who beats our drum and is in all of our parades. Can we do 2 minutes?
Hello. I'm speaking today on behalf of the Minnesota Voters Alliance. The Minnesota Voter Alliance staff, volunteers, and partners are engaged in the most wide-ranging and significant legal actions since the MVA was founded as a 501c4 in 2005. As you may know, our work focuses on the legal arena, a complex theater of operations. The issues are fundamental, the practitioners are few, and our efforts require years of perseverance. The MVA is the only conservative organization in Minnesota dedicated to expanding liberty through legal action. Determined to strike at the illegal liberal forces which degrade and reduce our freedoms. Our recent successes are a direct result of the generous support we receive from patriots like you who also believe in fighting to expand liberty. We are asking for your support in 2014. Media outlets from near and far have recognized the work of the MVA. We have been highlighted on the Fox News Channel, Wall Street Journal, the Jason Lewis and Hugh Hewitt radio shows, local TV and radio stations, as well as more than a dozen high-profile op-ed pieces in the Minneapolis Star Tribune, Boom, and the St. Paul Pioneer Press. We are working hard on these following 5 major goals: stopping ineligible voting with an Election Day registration lawsuit, challenging Governor Dayton's misuse of state funds, protecting taxpayer money from illegal promotion of ballot levies, opposing IRS tax status of the League of Women Voters and other liberal groups, and safeguarding vulnerable adults from voting exploitation. We are proud to announce that our most recent victory is our case against the Anoka-Hennepin School District. There we complained that the school district lacks the authority to promote ballot levies with taxpayer money. The Minnesota Court of Appeals remanded the lower court's dismissal on statute of limitation grounds. We are awaiting scheduling an order on this case. Today, I'm asking your request to support the MVA's impending lawsuit aimed at requiring Minnesota to verify the eligibility of every voter during the 2014 elections and beyond. If successful, this legal action will prevent what occurred in 2008. The U.S. Senate became filibuster-proof with the election of Al Franken by a mere 312 votes out of 2.9 million cast. In that race, more than 500,000 voters registered on Election Day voted and had their eligibility verified after the election. Our data request and the review of documentation revealed that more than 48,000 of these 500,000 individuals could not be confirmed as eligible voters. Please take a moment to review our handout and stop by our table to say hi. Thank you.